gathered here to honor Professor Surjeet Khalsa, retired professor, Department of History, Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar, who has the rare distinction of rendering all the plays of Shakespeare into Punjabi. I request Professor Khalsa to grace the dais with his presence. Thank you. I would like to invite Professor Bhimas Dahiya to the podium to deliver his welcome address.
Thirty, he's busy with his work. Then he has to leave at 12 o'clock for a meeting in Chandigarh with the Chief Secretary. So during that half an hour, we'll do the award ceremony. The rest of the proceedings will continue. So I welcome you all to this very proud day for the Indian universities and the academic community that we have amongst us today. Professor Surjeet Hans, who has done an outstanding work in translating all the 39 plays of Shakespeare into Punjabi. Professor Hans was professor of history at Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar. That was 20 years ago. And after his retirement, he devoted all the 20 years to this translation work. So 39 plays, roughly two plays a year he was doing. I may tell you, all the plays of Shakespeare have been translated in all the languages of the world. However, no single scholar in any language, French, German, Russian, etc., has done all the plays which Professor Hans alone has done. Others is a team of scholars. I sent mail to some outstanding scholars of Shakespeare, internationally known, about this award ceremony and about Professor Hans, about his work. Two of them immediately responded. The first one is Professor R.S. White. He is from Australia, Winthrop Professor of English, the University of Western Australia, a very well-known Shakespeare scholar. He has more than half a dozen books to his credit on the Bard of Stratford. He says, "What an amazing feat and wonderful achievement for Professor Hans. Great congratulations are in order." Unquote. Then another scholar, very well known, Rita Saveri. She is also professor of Shakespeare in Italy, University of Verona. So I sent a mail to her also, and this is what she says. "Congratulations to Professor Surjeet Hans for this outstanding result in bringing two civilizations closer together," unquote. And Professor Hans made me a poet for a short while. I couldn't resist myself scribbling a few lines about him. Here is the piece. The title is "On First Looking into Surjeet's Shakespeare." You would recall John Keats, "On First Looking into Chapman's Homer." Chapman had also translated Homer in the 16th century. So when Keats looked into their translation, he felt excited. He was very young, one-third my age. I'm not as excited, but couldn't help being excited. So the poem goes, "Is this the man who put into Punjabi? Is this the man, you remember? Is this the face, Helen? Is this the man who put into Punjabi all the 39 plays of Shakespeare and scaled the topless towers of Stratford? Is this the man, I keep on wondering, who went about in everyday world like a commoner at his usual routine, giving no inkling about the incredible work that he was doing these 20 years. When I consider Surjit Shakespeare, the English poet John Keats comes to mind, who on first looking into Chapman's Homer had felt excited like never before. I would rate Surjit rather higher than Chapman, whose Homer into English was not as exacting a literary task as Surjit's Shakespeare into Punjabi. That's all. Good, go quicker so we can begin with that.
We now have some sonnets of Shakespeare translated into Urdu by Professor K.K. Rishi, our guest of honor today. While the sonnets would be recited in English by different members of the Shakespeare Association, the Urdu versions of all would be rendered by Professor Rishi. I call upon the stage Professor Satnam Kaur to recite sonnet number 18. To be a part of this august gathering of Shakespearean scholars. Here I have been asked to recite sonnet number 18. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose the position that fair thou owest, nor shall the death brag thou wanderest in his shade, nor shall the death brag thee. So long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
मैं इस सोनेट नंबर 18 जो है इसका तर्जुमा उर्दू में आपके सामने पेश करने जा रहा हूँ। एक छोटी सी बात का आप जानते होंगे वैसे कि शेक्सपियर ने जो सिम्बलीज या मेटाफर्स दे रखे हैं वो अपने मुल्क के मुताबिक दे रखे हैं। जैसे इसी सोनेट में यह है, शल आई कंपेयर दी टू अ समर्स डे। हिंदुस्तान में ऐसा कोई नहीं करेगा। एनीवे तो तर्जमा इस तरह है कि तुझे हम गर्मियों का दिन कहें तो क्या मजा होगा, तुझे हम गर्मियों का दिन कहें तो क्या मजा होगा, नहीं हरगिज नहीं ये फैसला तो नारवा होगा। तू सूरज की ज़िया से भी ज्यादा खूबसूरत है, ज्यादा मुस्तकिल है तेरे जिस्मो जहाँ की रानाई। कभी तपता है ये सूरज, कभी छुपता है ये सूरज, इसी गर्दिश में रहती हैं जमाने की हसीन चीजें। कभी किस्मत की खूबी से, कभी कुदरत के हाथों से, मगर तेरा ये हुस्ने लापना है दायम और कायम, कि जिसको मौत के भी हाथ हरगिज छू न पाएंगे।
तेरे शेरों में तू है और तेरा हुस्न कामिल है कि जब तक इस जमीन पर जिंदगानी सांस लेती है मेरे अशआर तुझको जिंदा और जावेद रखेंगे।
With her rendition of sonnet number 55.
Not marble, not the gilded monument, but the living record of your memory. Against death and all oblivious enmity shall you pace forth. Your praise shall still find room, even in the eyes of all posterity, that wear this world out to the ending doom. So till the judgment that yourself arise, you live in this and dwell in lovers' eyes.
निशान ये शान शौकत के सुनहरी मकबरे ये यादगार शहरयारों की मेरे अशआर से बढ़कर नहीं पाएगी इनमें मेरे अशआर ही में याद तेरी जो खुशां होगी कि इन सब मकबरों महलों फसीलों को हिसारों को गुजरते वक्त की जालिम हवा मिसवार कर देगी सभी ये खूबसूरत पुत बनेंगे लुकमाए वहशत के जंगों की तबाही इन सभी को रौन डालेगी यही तो हशर होगा इन फनकारों की मेहनत का मगर अशआर मेरे तेरी यादों से सजे संवरे रहेंगे जिंदा और जावेद इस तखरीब कारी में मिटा देती है जो नामो निशान हस्ती से बंदों के मेरे शेरों में तेरे हुस्न की तारीफ दायम है कि इनको ता कयामत सारी दुनिया याद रखेगी सभी मसरूर होंगे याद से तेरी मोहब्बत की तू इन शार में जिंदा रहेगी और ये दुनिया रहेगी प्यार करती ताब तुझको मेरी जान।
University and Shakespeare Association for inviting us here to be a part of this program. Sonnet number 65 is about how time overpowers everything. And nothing can be it brass, stone, earth, or the boundless sea, or gates of steel. Nothing can stand in front of time, except for a miracle that Shakespeare talks about. Sonnet 65. Since brass, nor stone, nor earth, nor boundless sea, but sad mortality oversways their power. How with this rage shall beauty hold a plea, whose action is no stronger than a flower? Oh, how shall summer's honey breath hold out against the wrathful siege of battering days, when rocks impregnable are not so stout, nor gates of steel so strong, but time decays? Oh, fearful meditation! Where, Allah, shall time's best jewel from time's chest lie in? Or what strong hand can hold his swift foot back? Or who his spoil or beauty can forbid? Oh, none, unless this miracle have might.
I find that वो बहरे बेकरा हो माफ करना बीच बीच में कुछ ऐसा भी है बना के सामने सब देश हैं अशआर पाइंदा वो बहरे बेकरा हो या जमीन हो या संगो वजूद मखमली जिसका है फूलों से भी नाजुक तर नफस की खुशबुएं आखिर करेंगी सामना कब तक गुजरते वक्त के खूंखार और जालिम थपेड़ों का नहीं टिकती कि जिनके रूबरू पत्थर की चट्टाने या जिनसे बच नहीं सकते दरो दीवारे आहन भी वही तो वक्त का डाकू चुरा ले जाएगा एक दिन किसी नाजुक बदन के खूबसूरत हुस्न का जेवर मगर एक मार का इसको बचा सकता है आलम में अगर रोहो कलम की हुस्ने जाना बन सके जीना।
Now I am invited to present sonnet number 91.
Good morning, friends. This is sonnet 91. Some glory in their wealth, some in their skin, some in their wealth, some in their body stores, some in their garments. Though newfangled ill, jumped pleasure, where it finds the joy above the rest. But these particulars are not my measure. All these I better in one general best. Thy love is better than high birth to me, richer than wealth, prouder than more than garments cost, of more delight than hawks and horses be, and having thee of all men's pride, I boast, wretched in this alone, that thou mayest take all this away, and me most wretched make. Thank you.
Yes, and सॉनेट नंबर 91 का तर्जमा आपके सामने पेश कर रहा हूँ। किसी को नाज है पैदा हुआ ऊंचे घराने में, कोई अपनी हुनरमंदी पे ही फिरता है इतराता, कुछ अपनी दौलत तो ताकत के गुर्रे में मुलव्वस हैं, अकड़ कर चलने वाले हैं कई तुरफा लिबासों में, कई घोड़ों परिंदों पर ही अपने नाज करते हैं, दिखावे की ये सब चीजें हैं सामा उनको राहत से नहीं मेरे लिए, लेकिन मसरत के ये पैमाने, इन सबसे कहीं बढ़कर मुझे तेरी मोहब्बत है, मुकाबल जिसके गोया हेज है सतबत के सब सामा, घरानों की हो असबत क्या गुरूरे जाहो हशमत को, इन असबाब से तेरी मोहब्बत बेश कीमत है, यकीनन फखर के काबिल मुझे तेरी मोहब्बत है, मगर हाँ एक खटका भी है इसके साथ वाबस्ता, अगर तू खींच ले दामन कभी अपनी मोहब्बत का, तो मेरी जिंदगी एक दर्द की तस्वीर बन जाए।
थैंक यू प्रोफेसर प्रकाश एंड प्रोफेसर ऋषि। नाउ आई कॉल ऑन द स्टेज मिस प्रीति सिंह, रिसर्च स्कॉलर JNU, to present sonnet number 106.
Good morning, friends. Sonnet 106. When in the chronicle of wasted time, I see descriptions of the fairest wives and beauty making beautiful old rhyme.
तो आते हैं नजर कितने हसीन लोगों के अफसाने, कि जिनका हुस्न मूजिब था हसीन अशआर कहने का, वो किस्से नाज़नीनों के, वो बातें नौजवानों की, बयाने दस्तों का या फिर लबो रुख की वो तारीफें, पुराने शायरों के दिलनशीं अंदाज के नगमे तुम्हारे हुस्न बेपाया पे ही लिखे गए होंगे, उन्हें मालूम था शायद कि तुम इतने हसीन होंगे, तुम्हारा हुस्न ही उनके तसव्वुर में रहा होगा, कि हम इस दौर के शायर तो ऐसा लिख नहीं सकते, हमारे पास आंखें हैं फकत हैरान होने को, ज़बान लेकिन नहीं है हुस्न की तारीफ करने को।
The last one is sonnet number 116, being presented by Professor Lavleen Mohan, Department of English, MD University, Rohtak.
Dedicated to the emotion of love, the indomitable devotion of love. Sonnet 116. Let me not to the marriage of true minds admit impediments. Love is not love which alters when its alteration finds, or bends with the remover to remove. Oh no, it's an ever fixed rock that looks on tempests and is never shaken. It's the star to every wandering bark, whose worth is unknown, although his height be taken. Love is not time's fool, though rosy lips and cheeks within his bending sickle's compass come. Love alters not with his brief hours and weeks, but bears it out even to the edge of doom. If this be error, and upon me proved, I never writ, nor no man ever loved. Thank you.
सबसे पहले इस सॉनेट का मैंने ट्रांसलेट किया था, वो भी प्रोफेसर भैया साहब की माँ पर, बहुत पहले। तो उसके है कि कोई सच्चे दिलों के बीच क्यों दीवार बन जाए, उन्हें मिलने से क्यों रोके कोई गर्दिश जमाने की, मोहब्बत वो नहीं है जो बदल जाए तगैयुर से, या झुक जाए झुकाने से, या मिट जाए मिटाने से, ये एक रोशन मनारा है तलातम बे असर इस पर, सदा साबित साबित कदम रहता है ये तूफान के आगे, मोहब्बत वो सितारा है जो हर भटके सफीने की किया करता है हरदम रहनुमाई जुल्मते शब में। मोहब्बत वक्त की तादे नहीं है ये मगर सच है, बदन की दिलकशी तो उसकी जद में आ ही जाती है। मोहब्बत फिर भी रहती है हमेशा दायम और कायम के माहो साल का इस पर असर कुछ भी नहीं होता। मोहब्बत कम नहीं होती, मोहब्बत मिट नहीं सकती। अगर मैं झूठ कहता हूँ तो ये ऐलान है मेरा, जो लिखा है अभी तक मैंने सब बेकार लिखा है, तो किसी ने भी नहीं की है मोहब्बत सारी दुनिया में।
Professor Rishi, a huge round of applause for Professor Rishi for the beautiful effort. Moving on with the day's program, we will now have some famous speeches from Shakespeare rendered by the members of the Shakespeare Association, first in English, followed by their translation in Punjabi, as has been done by Professor Hans.
This opportunity to congratulate Professor Sujit Hans. I really feel honored to be here, and I'm going to read one of the speeches of Juliet from Romeo and Juliet. Tell me not, friar, that thou hearest of this, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it. If in thy wisdom thou canst give no help, do thou but call my resolution wise. And with this knife I'll help it presently. God joined my heart and Romeo, thou our hands. And earth is hand by thee to Romeo's seed, shall be the label to another deed. All my true heart with treacherous revolt, turn to another, this shall slay them both. Therefore, out of thy long experienced time, give me some present counsel, or behold, twist my extremes and need this bloody knife, shall play the empire, arbitrating that which the commission of thy years and art could to no issue of true honor bring. Be not so long to speak. I long to die, if for though speakers speak not of remedy. Thank you.
This is the Punjabi translation, translated by Professor Surjit Hans. ऐसी बात को ना संतो जड़ी केड़ी सुन रखी है, जेकर तुझे मैनू दसना नहीं है रोक बनानी किंज है, जेकर तुझे अकल सियानप खड़ी नहीं है मेरी सहायता, ता फिर मेरे एक इरादे नू है आपे ही चंगा कहना, जो मैं एस करद ना अपनी करदी होवां एन सहायता, रब ने मुझ रोमियो दिल जोड़े हैं, तुझने हस्त असाडे हस्त मेरा जो रोमियो हस्त फड़ाया, तुझने मोर तरंदी लाई, हो नहीं सकता किधरे होर वसीके उते अखर पावे, जो मेरा जो दिल मेरा सच्चा किधरे धोखेबाजी गलत गदर करे है होर किसे लड़ लाके, मैं दोहां नू आपे वड़ दूंगी, इस करके फिर अपने तीरग काली अनुभव विचों कोई देवो मैनू मता मशहूरत हाल कड़ी दा, नहीं तो वेखो एक पासे मेरी अतताई दूजे पासे खूनी खंजर, जिसने आप सालसी करनी कीमत हस्त जिले होना है, जो तुद वाला अधिकरम की सालों साल कलादा बनया, करना सकिया ठीक मामला मेरा अधिमान संग, इन्नी देर है कान कारी लाई मैं ता तुली मौत ते होई, जेकर बचन तो हाड़ा करना सकिया उपाय कोई। थैंक यू।
If he fails to return the money in time, defending Antonio in the court, Portia seeks mercy from Shylock. In this speech, and very cleverly turns the tables on him. I request Dr. Nina Arora, Associate Professor in English, Dayal Singh College, Karnal, to render this speech.
A moment of great honor, reading this speech from this great play by Shakespeare before this August gathering, and after congratulating Dr. Sujit Hans and expressing my gratitude to Dr. Daya for providing me this opportunity, I read out this speech. The quality of mercy is not supreme. It droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven upon the place beneath. It's twice blessed. It blesseth him that gives and him that takes. It's mightiest in the mightiest. It becomes the throne monarch better than his crown. His scepter shows the force of his temporal power, the attribute to awe and majesty, wherein doth sit the dread and fear of kings. But mercy is above this sceptered tree. It is enthroned in the hearts of kings. It is an attribute to God himself. And the earthly power doth then show likest God's when mercy seasons justice. Therefore, Jew, though justice be thy plea, consider this, that in the course of justice, none of us should see salvation. We do pray for mercy, and that same prayer doth teach us all to render the deeds of mercy. I have spoke thus much to mitigate the justice of thy plea, which if thou follow, this separate court of Venice must needs give judgment against the merchant there. Now the Punjabi translation. शाइलॉक कहता है, रहम जरूरी किस कारण है बंदा, ये समझाओ मैं। ते पोर्शिया जवाब देती है, गुण जेड़ा की रहम दिली दा, खेंचा तानी बात नहीं है, ए ता सूखम वर्षा वांगू, अंबरा तो ही डिगदी होवे, थलड़ी पोए उत्ते। रहमत एदी दो तरफा है जेड़ी, जो करते ते रहमत हुंदी, जो प्राप्त रहमत मिलती, वीर उत्तम विच वीर उत्तम है कि शोभा दिंदी है जेड़ी, आपे शाहे तकदार नू ओदे ताज बने तो बोदी, ओदा राज दंड जो लौकिक शक्ति दा प्रतीक रहा है, जेड़ा लच्छन जा जलाल दा ओदी शान तमकनत वाला, जिस विच रिहा स्थित की पीम त्रा जो खौफ शाहाना, रहम दिली जो बाला हुंदी राज दंड दी रुकम रवि तू, एदा अपना तखत रहा जो बनिया शाह दिलां दे अंदर, ते की ए ता वसफ रहा है आपे रब रहीम दा जिकन, नाले लौकिक शक्ति जेड़ी ओवी रबानी है लगदी, जब इंसान जब इंसाफ रहम नाल कुल मिल जांदा, ते फिर सुने यहूदी, पावे तेरा अपना दावा रहा न्यादा, सोचन दी है, जे आधार न्यादा हुवे, ता फिर साडे विचों एक वी, बंदे दीने मुक्ति हुने, रोज दुआ रहमत दी मंदी, उलट सौदा करते हैं।
It is indeed our pleasure to have amongst us Lieutenant General D.D.S. Sandhu, Vice Chancellor, Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra, as the Chief Guest. Moving on with this part of the day's program, we now have Antonio's speech from Julius Caesar. Caesar has been murdered by conspirators, including Brutus.
You all do know this mantle, I remember, the first time ever Caesar put it on. It was on a summer's evening in his tent. That day he overcame the Nervi. Look in this place, ran Caesar's dagger through. See what a rent the envious casca made. Through this the well-beloved Brutus stabbed, and as he plucked his cursed steel away, mark how the blood of Caesar followed. As rushing out of doors to be resolved, if Brutus so unkindly knocked, or no, for Brutus, as you know, was Caesar's angel. Judge, O you gods, how dearly Caesar loved him. This was the most unkindest cut of all, for when the noble Caesar saw him stab, ingratitude, more strong than Tatus arm, quite vanquished him. Then brushed his mighty heart, and in his mantle muffling up his face, even at the base of Pompey's statue, which all the wild and glad great Caesar fell. Oh, what a fall was there, my countrymen. Then I and you and all of us fell down, whilst bloody Trajan flourished over us. Oh, now you weep, and I perceive you feel the dint of pity. These are gracious drops. Kind souls, what weep you when you but behold our Caesar's wretched wounded? Look, you hear, here is himself marred, as you see, we traitors. Thank you.
Yes. I read out the Punjabi version of that oft quoted quotation by Anthony. Ji hanju han tade kol ta suttan layi karo tiyari tusi is te change to jaano mainu yaad hai sara jis vele Caesar ne ki is nu paya si pehli wari apne tambu di rut garmi di shaam tali si jikar jis vele usne narvi gan te kiti si jit prapat. देखो इतने जितों कैशियस का खंजर लगदा होया तको चीरो चीरे नू फिर जेड़ा के बद खा कस के दिता जो इतों दी की है बहुत प्रिय ब्रोटस शुरा चलाया ते जो ए बाहर नू अपना पापी लोह सी खिचदा होया देखो दत सी जदा इसे मगरों मगरी किकर अजी आई जिकर बाहर नू सी जिवे जानर चौदे पक्का सच्ची आप ब्रोटस ने सी ਅਣ ਪ੍ਰਕਿਰਤਿਕ ਸੱਟ ਲਗਾਈ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਦੇ ਹੋ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਬਰੂਟਸ ਸੀਜ਼ਰ ਵਾਲੀ ਪੀਰੀ ਆਤਮਾ ਸਮਝੋ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਵਗਣ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਮਹਿੰਗਾ ਮੋਹ ਪਿਆ ਸੀਜ਼ਰ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਥਾਉ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਕਾਮ ਹੈ ਲੱਗਾ ਅਤਿ ਕਰੂਰ ਤੇ ਅਤਿ ਅਸ਼ ਪ੍ਰਕਿਰਤਿਕ ਗੱਲ ਕੀ ਜਦੋਂ ਆਰਿਆ ਸੀਜ਼ਰ ਨੇ ਸੀ ਡਿੱਠਾ ਵਾਰ ਜੋ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਕਿਰਤ ਕਰਦਾ ਸੀ ਅਤਿ ਸ਼ਕਤ ਵਰ ਗਿਰਦਾਰੀ ਦੇ ਵਾਜੂ ਨਾਲੋਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਇਸਨੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਡਿੱਗਦੇ ਕੀਤਾ ਤੇ ਮਹਾਂ ਗਿਰਤ ਦਾ ਫੜਦਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਉਹਨੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਚੰਗੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੀ ਲਿਆ ਲਪੇੜ ਸੀ ਚਿਹਰਾ ਆਪਣਾ ਤੇ ਜੇ ਪੀਠ ਸੰਵਰਗ ਕੌਂਪੀ ਵਾਲੀ ਤੇ ਦੀ ਰੱਥ ਦੀ ਵਗੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਸੀਜ਼ਰ ਡਾਟਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਲੱਗਿਆ ਆਏ ਮੇਰੇ ਦੇਸ਼ਵਾਸੀਓ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਪਤਨ ਰਿਹਾ ਸੀ ਕੈਸਾ ਉਹ ਵੇਲੇ ਮੈਂ ਆਪ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜੋ ਆਪਾਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਡਿੱਗਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਸਾਡੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਖੂਨੀ ਆਪ ਤਰੋ ਦਾ ਚੁੱਕਦਾ ਹੋਇਆ ਹਾਏ ਹੁਣ ਰੋਵੋ ਫਿਰ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਨਜ਼ਰ ਆਵੇ ਭਾਵ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਵੱਜੀ ਸੱਟ ਤਰਸ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਤੁਪਕੇ ਆਪ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਹਨ ਡਿੱਗਦੇ ਭਲਿਓ ਪੁੱਛੋ ਕਿੱਕਣ ਰੋਵੋਗੇ ਫਿਰ ਐਸਾ ਜੋ ਵੇਖੋਗੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਸੀਜ਼ਰ ਵਾਲੇ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਜ਼ਖਮੀ ਲਓ ਫਿਰ ਵੇਖ ਲਓ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਸੰਨਿਆਸ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਹੈ ਵੇਖੋ ਕਿਦਾਰਾ ਦੀ ਕਰਨ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ
My reaction to your kindness is none goes so far as he who knows not where he is going. It's my enjoyable obligation to acknowledge my gratitude to you for inviting me to this function. The less I speak, the more I owe my gratefulness. Let me borrow from Shakespeare, Troilus tells Cressida, few words for fair faith. I hope my few words would convey more my fair faith in you. Now, Professor Daya has asked me to put in some kind of performance. I read to you first Seven Ages of Man in English and then in Punjabi. So Professor Daya had a brilliant team of readers and translators. I'm glad to say that they were much better than I am, and that is my happiness. All the world's states, they have their exits and their entrances. And one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being seven ages. At first the infant, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms. Then the whining schoolboy with his satchel and shining morning face, creeping like snail unwillingly to school. And then the lover, sighing like furnace, with a woeful mirror made to his mistress's eyebrow. The soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like the palm, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation in the cannon's mouth. And then the justice in fair round belly, with good caper lined, with eyes severe and beard a formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances, and so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful hose well saved, a world too wide for his shrug shank, and his big manly voice turning again toward childish trouble, pipes and whistles in his sound, last uniform that ends the strange eventful history, his second childishness, and mere oblivion, sans feet, sans eyes, sans taste, sans everything. ਸਰਗੀ ਮੁੱਖ ਤਾਂ ਸਰਗੀ ਵਰਗਾ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਜੋ ਸੁਨੇਲ ਦੀ ਚਾਲ ਹੈ ਤੁਰਦਾ ਬੇਮਨ ਮਦਰਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਤੇ ਫਿਰ ਬਾਂਕਾ ਆਸ਼ਿਕ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਆਹਾਂ ਦਾ ਕੀ ਲੂੰਬਾ ਨਿਕਲੇ ਨਾਲੇ ਕੱਚ ਕਵਿਸ਼ਰੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਪਤਕਾ ਦੇ ਭਰਵੱਟੇ ਵਾਲੀ ਤੇ ਫਿਰ ਕੀ ਹੈ ਯੋਧੀ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਗਾਲਾਂ ਨਵੀਆਂ ਅਤੇ ਨਰੋਈਆਂ ਦਾੜੀ ਕੁਤਰੀ ਚੀਤਾ ਲੱਗੇ ਅਭਿਮਾਨ ਦਾ ਪਹਿਰਾ ਦਿੰਦਾ ਝਟਪਟ ਕਾਲਾ ਝਗੜੇ ਨੂੰ ਹੈ ਪਹਾੜੇ ਮਸ਼ਹੂਰੀ ਦਾ ਸੂਨ ਬੁਲਬੁਲਾ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਤੋਪ ਦੇ ਮੂੰਹ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਤੇ ਫਿਰ ਜੱਜ ਬਣ ਕੇ ਹੈ ਬਹਿੰਦਾ ਚੰਗਾ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਢਿੱਡ ਕੱਢਿਆ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਅੰਦਰ ਮੁਰਗੇ ਦਾ ਲੱਗਿਆ ਰੱਖਦਾ ਰੂਪ ਨਜ਼ਰ ਹੈ ਆਪਣੀ ਦਾੜੀ ਕਥਾ ਵਜ਼ਾ ਨਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਕਥਨ ਕਹਾਵਤ ਦਾ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਭਾਵਾਂ ਮਸਾਲਾ ਦੱਸਦਾ ਆਪਣੀ ਕਰੀ ਭੂਮਿਕਾ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਜੋ ਛੇਵੀਂ ਸੰਕ੍ਰਾਂਤ ਬਣੀ ਹੈ ਦੁਬਲਾ ਪਤਲਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਸਲੀਪਰ ਧਾਰੀ ਕੀ ਪਤਲੂਨ ਵਸਤਰ ਐਨਕ ਧਰੀ ਨੱਕ ਤੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੀ ਜੋ ਪਾਸੇ ਤੇ ਗੁਤਲੀ ਲਟਕੇ ਰੱਖੀ ਸਾਂਭ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਜੋਬਨ ਰੁੱਤਦੀ ਲੰਬੀ ਚੌੜੀ ਦੁਨੀਆਂ ਉਹਦੀ ਦੂਜਾ ਬਚਪਨ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਉੱਕਾ ਸਮਰ ਅਤਿਕ ਦੀ ਮਾਇਆ ਜਿੱਕਣ ਦੰਤ ਰਹਿਤ ਹੈ ਚਕਸ਼ ਰਹਿਤ ਹੈ ਸੋਹਜ ਸਵਾਦ ਰਹਿਤ ਜੋ ਸਭ ਕੁਛ
ਲੇਡੀਜ਼ ਐਂਡ ਜੈਂਟਲਮੈਨ ਆਈ ਫੀਲ ਪ੍ਰਿਵਿਲੇਜ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰੈਜੈਂਟ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਦਿਸ ਆਗਸਟ ਅਸੈਂਬਲੀ ਦਾ ਸਾਈਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਫਾਰ ਦਾ ਸ਼ੇਕਸਪੀਅਰ ਅਵਾਰਡ ਬੀਇੰਗ ਆਫਰਡ ਟੂਡੇ ਟੂ ਪ੍ਰੋਫੈਸਰ ਸੁਰਜੀਤ ਹੰਸ ਫਾਰ ਹਿਜ਼ ਆਊਟਸਟੈਂਡਿੰਗ ਵਰਕ ਇਨ ਟ੍ਰਾਂਸਲੇਟਿੰਗ all the 39 plays of Shakespeare into Punjabi. The Shakespeare Association takes pride in honoring Professor Surjit Hans with the Shakespeare Award, which he eminently deserves by virtue of his exceptional work in the field of translation. They say, Rome was not built in a day, nor was Shakespeare in Punjabi, I would like to add. Just as Shakespeare took 20 years to produce his 39 plays of exceptional merit, so did Professor Hans in translating the Bard's plays. It will not be out of place here to say that there is a certain robustness in the language and culture of Punjab which closely resembles the language and culture of Shakespeare's England. It is quite remarkable that Professor Hans took care to use the spoken language for retaining the vibrancy of the original English. which ranges from rural rusticity to royal elegance. When I think of Professor Hans battling for 20 long years with words and phrases, capturing tones and textures, cruising with ironies and paradoxes, wading through the low currents and high tides of linguistic navigation. When I think of him negotiating all these impediments for 20 long years, I am reminded of the Homeric hero, Odysseus, who too had spent 20 years first braving the war of Troy and then overcoming the hurdles on his way back home. I do not hesitate to say that Professor Hans's journey into the world of words was no less heroic than that of Odysseus through the world of swords. The Shakespeare Award being conferred on him today is only a token recognition of his Odyssean accomplishment. Professor Surjit Hans, I may remind the August Assembly, taught history for over 3 decades and finally retired as professor from Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar. He may have tied his knot with history in his public life. In his private hours, he continued his love affair with literature. Not surprisingly, it was only after he had discharged all his public responsibilities that he completely gave himself to his abiding love for Shakespeare. Turning his back on all public activities, he almost went into hiding, devoting all his time to translating Shakespeare into Punjabi. This long span of sacrifice and devotion climaxed into the production of his gigantic work in Punjabi language. Credit should also be given to Punjabi University Patiala for publishing all his works in elegant volumes. That Professor Hans, a scholar of history, fell in love with the poetry of Shakespeare should not come as a surprise to anyone, for it had not happened without an acquaintance. Professor Hans, let me disclose to those not familiar with his education career, had also done his master's degree in English from Punjab University way back in 1956. It was during these 2 years as a student of MA English at Hoshiarpur that he had come under the spell of Shakespeare's art. Not only that he had read more Shakespeare than prescribed in his reading course, he had also taken part as an actor in several plays of Shakespeare staged during those 2 years. Between 1956, when he did his MA in English, and the year 1993, when he retired from his teaching career, he kept his affair with Shakespeare all these years as a closely guarded secret. The affair surfaced only recently when the publication of his translation work was flashed in the national newspapers. Now, when the profound work of Professor Hans has suddenly come to light, we are left wondering about his rarest of the rare love and devotion to scholarly work. Thinking of the lasting fame Professor Hans has earned for himself, I am reminded of a sonnet of Shakespeare which states, "Not marble nor the gilded monuments or princes shall outlive this powerful rhyme, but you shall shine more bright in these contents than unswept stone be smeared with sluttish time." With this brief note accompanying the Shakespeare Award for Professor Surjit Hans, I, on behalf of the Shakespeare Association, pay our sincere tribute to the distinguished scholar for his peerless translation of Shakespeare. I request the Honorable Chief Guest, the Vice Chancellor of Kurukshetra University, General D.D.S. Sandhu, to kindly present the prestigious award.
That's it. अब लीजिए भी ना।
हाँ 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 सामने है यार।
Person of the English Department, other members of the Shakespearean Association, faculty members, ladies, gentlemen, and lovers of for translating Shakespeare into Punjabi, the complete works of Shakespeare. Punjabi has always been associated with a rather rustic character. So, and Shakespeare at the other end is the acme of linguistic perfection. I mean, one grew up in some kind of Indian schools which masqueraded as English public schools, and Shakespeare, quoting Shakespeare was considered to be the absolutely that you were very erudite if you could talk about Shakespeare or quote him, and so that way, so whereas Punjabi is particularly for somebody like me who's been in the forces for almost 40 years before I went into the academic world, a Punjabi sentence is never complete unless there is some masala added to it. So therefore, I was very, very impressed when I saw this huge article on him in the Daily Post. I'm sure it must have been covered in a number of other places also. But translating the entire works of Shakespeare into Punjabi is totally a phenomenal effort. And the way, whatever I have heard, at least two of these speeches, one by the professor from CDLU, Chaudhary, I think, and one from the great Professor Hans himself. And I thought to myself that it is really, really done well. I mean, it catches the essence of Shakespeare as Shakespeare should be taught and as Shakespeare should be listened to. I was asking him, and I still don't know how actually Et tu, Brute can be translated. I just smiled and didn't give an answer to it. So I don't still be interested in finding out how classic line like that could be translated into Punjabi. But it is, I am always in my little forays into reading, I have always considered there are three perfect prose writers or poetry writers that have existed in this world, for me at least. One is, of course, Ghalib. I don't think anybody can touch Ghalib. And the second is Shakespeare. And the third, I dare say, those of who have read it, is the Gurbani, is the Guru Granth Sahib. If somebody actually goes through, so therefore, if you go line by line, to some of you I would suggest that every morning when you get onto the net, just there is a Hukamnama which comes from the Harmandir Sahib, and that along with that they give you the translation of that, and if you read that you will actually come to know the beauty of the world. So therefore, the beauty of the written word probably lies in these three expositions of linguistic perfection. So it's a great, great effort for Professor Hans, and it's a great boon for all of us to have been blessed in this our mother tongue to have come and read, because ultimately there are only, I think, maybe 15-20% people who actually have a good grip on English and who can savour the pleasure of Shakespeare. So once it is translated into Punjabi, the reach will be much more, and it will hopefully get our students to enjoy one of the great writers of this world. Actually, whenever one reads to Shakespeare, and it is almost 400 years old, but you still find him very, very relevant. Some of the topics that he's talked about, the language, the language itself has not become outdated, the one he has used. I don't know if it's whether the controversy, whether Shakespeare himself has written those plays or somebody else has written them for him, and he was a fraud who never paid his taxes and all. Very interesting kind of a personality. But all that cannot take away from the brilliance of Shakespeare. And I think as a nation, particularly those who are Punjabi speaking, we should be eternally grateful to Professor Harsh for making this great effort. And sir, we are very grateful to you that you have chosen Kushetra University and Professor Zaya, who is a great lover of Shakespeare himself, to have used this, to have given this honor to Kushetra University, of which he has been the Vice Chancellor also. So it's a great day for Kushetra University, and I hope that this great cultural property that is being bequeathed to us today will find it get permeated to all across the country and abroad, wherever Punjabi lovers are there. I am grateful to think which we need to propagate. There is a lot of angst against the English language in our country, and we need people like you, those who are literary loving, those who read English for the sake. It's a beautiful language, let me tell you. There is absolutely no gainsaying the fact. Every language is beautiful in its own way, but the kind of beauty which is there in English, I think that needs to be propagated also to all over the world, to which Professor Hans has made an eternal contribution, I would say. Thank you.
Association to present a memento to the chief guest.
What did Shakespeare say about the rose?
Professor Anand Prakash, Vice President, the Shakespeare Association, to present a memento to Professor.
An enterprise of great pitch and moment, with disregard, this current turn away, and lose the name of action. Soft you now. The fair Ophelia, nymph in the Orishans, be all my sins deepened.
Jan Sandhu, our Vice Chancellor, he had posed the question, how, I don't know, how act of brute will be translated into Punjabi. I don't know how Professor Hans will translate it, but in Haryanvi I can translate it, say, अरे ब्रूटस्ट ने चाला कर दिया एनीवे थिंग लिया एक्ट वन सीन वन पीस कैंट कम नॉट बिटवीन द ड्रैगन एंड हिज रॉथ आई लव हर मोस्ट एंड थॉट टू सेट माय रेस्ट ऑन अ काइंड नर्सरी हेंस एंड अवॉइड माय साइट सो बी माय ग्रेव माय पीस एज हियर आई गिव her father's heart from her. For France, Boosters, call Burgundy, Cornwall and Albany, with my two daughters' dowers, digest this third. Let pride, which she calls plainness, marry her. I do invest you jointly with my power, preeminence, and all the large effects that took with majesty. Ourself, by monthly course, by reservation of 100 nights, to be sustained by you, shall our abode make with you by due terms. Only us, which to confirm this coronet.